My lovelies, welcome back to my channel. So this is a zodiac reading for my lovely fire signs, so Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, but you know, you can have this in your chart, anyone can watch. And so it is what fortune will be smiling upon you guys. So let's have a look. So spirit tap me into my fire signs, what fortune will be smiling upon my lovely fire signs. Okay, so what have we got? Unity. So you guys got number 34, unity. A time of divine understanding, renewal, peace and hope. You radiate and attract great love. So, you know, this could be love with the divine. It can be peace if you've been having a hard time with, you know, family members or your partner. Or you could be attracting love right now. I mean, you never know, it might be the whole thing. So let's have a look. Rightio. So spirit, tell me more about this unity for my fire signs, please. Oh, six of cups. Okay. Straight away I'm seeing here for you guys, there's a reconciliation. Or it could be that you've had, you know, we've got a time or, hang on. So an understanding and a renewal and peace and hope. So it could be that you've been hoping for a reconciliation with someone, you know, someone from your past, someone from your childhood, you know, even a family member, it could be here. And it could even be a love as well. So you guys take what resonates, but there's something here that you miss about someone. Yeah, let's have a look. Tell me about the six of cups. So this is reunions. Tell me about the six of cups, please. Seven of coins and the five of swords and the ace of swords on the back of the deck. So something, it could be maybe, guys, you may be in touch with the divine, okay? It's like a telephone call, if it was that easy. But you guys may have just gotten in touch with your spiritual side, you know, done a lot more meditation, communicated with spirit more, you know, you could be talking to spirit, just asking for guidance here. And it's like, finally, you've seen the truth, you've seen the light. And that truth is here, is that whatever happened with this person from the past, nobody won in this. It looks like whoever this past person is, or persons, it's like you feel defeated, they feel defeated. I'm getting the energy of both sides literally are missing each other here. But it's like you, you're waiting here for something. Maybe you were waiting for this past person to reach out to you, but maybe spirit's saying now you need to take that step. You need to apologize. And what I'm seeing here is, okay, maybe you guys were expecting something like really, like, you know, a huge, I don't know, miracle, you know, finances or what have you, but my fire signs, this is something that touches your heart. And I am seeing here that I feel like you guys feel ashamed of maybe how you treated this past person, that you wasn't very nice to them, you may have judged them. But it's like you're at a standstill here of, do I reach out? Do I not reach out? So tell me a bit more, please, about this unity. Page of Wands in reverse. Tell me a bit more. So this is news that is delayed. It's not coming forward just yet. Tell me about this page of wands in reverse. So we do have Leo, Aries, Sagittarius right here. This is a new beginning. Tell me more about this page of wands in reverse and this ace of pentacles. This is being given a second chance, you know, a renewal of hope, of starting again, of building something with this person, you know. It's not broken is what I'm seeing. The Tower. And a bit more. Look at that, Ace of Cups. The World. So for some of you, it can be a friend, it can be a family member. It's like, I'm picking up here, without this person's love, without this person's affection, just in general, of just not having this person in your life has not been very easy. It's been very rocky. It's been, maybe you've gone through a lot of hardships recently. And it's like you've had this wake-up call, like I said, with the Ace of Swords here. Like you've seen the truth of what it is now. And you've learned a lesson here. Sometimes maybe life is too short. I'm just seeing that you've learned your lesson. It sounds quite bad, really, to say that like that. But there is a lot of love here for whoever this energy is. The energy is hiding. Tell me about this Tower. You know, it could be just a realization that, oh my God, I do really love this person. I do really want to start again. I do want to build with this person. Spirit is literally giving you a second chance here to do the right thing. If this is what you want, why are you holding back? Tell me about the Tower. Three of Swords. Page of Wands. Page of Wands and the Seven of Pentacles. So it could be that, you know, we've got the Seven of Pentacles again. You want to reach out, you want to communicate with this person, but it's like the reason why you're holding back, you're waiting, because it's like, are they going to break my heart? Are they going to reject me because I broke their heart? So it's like you're not very sure whether this is going to be a, you know, like it used to be, whether it's going to be a solid connection again. You know, is it going to be rocky? You do really love and respect this person, whoever this is. So we've got Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn here. So give me a bit more, please, here, Spirit. Actually, let's get some advice for you guys. What advice would you give? Okay, that's what. So Hierophant and the Wheel of Fortune. Ace of Cups again. Ugh. You know, this could be an old love. We've got the Three of Cups again on the back of the deck. Three of Cups on the back of the deck. This is a celebration. This is a reconciliation as well. This could be Spirit telling you, invite this person. Look at me chucking the tarot card thing. I'm getting really, like, you know, telling you to reach out to this person. Don't hold back no more. Reach out to this person. Ask them if they want to go out, you know, have a drink, have a meal, talk about things. If you're not sure, Spirit is saying to you, speak to someone that's more, I don't know, more mature than you. That sounds really bad and all. Not mature. Someone who is a bit more wiser than you, that can give you advice. Someone that is a trusted friend or a relative. You know, the wheel is about to change here for the good. But you just need to take action. You need to do something about this. If you want to change things, you know, the wheel is all about change. You just need to do it. But it is fear that's holding you back here. This could be someone that you do really respect. Like I said, the Hierophant, and the King of Pentacles. I do want to find out about this Three of Cups. This has come out twice now. Tell me about the Three of Cups for my fire sign, Blue Spirit. Five of Cups. Two of Swords. The Eight of Cups. And the Tower. Oh dear. And we do have the Star. Hang on. And we do have Justice. So we do have Libra, we do have Aquarius here. Yeah, the Three of Cups. No. Whoever this was to you, my fire signs, was your circle of support. Someone who would be like your biggest cheerleader, someone you could lean on. And whatever it was, I feel like it wasn't anything deep here, but you know, whatever happened caused you to feel rejected and unwanted. But Spirit is saying you are grieving for this person. You still may cry over losing this person here. And there is a fear here. You know, this is why you're holding back, because you're so fearful. Is this person going to reject me again? You know, it may have been they rejected you. It may have been the other way around. But there is a fear here. Am I going to be rejected if I come forward? Is it best to just leave it alone? Should I just give up? But then what I'm also seeing here on the other side of it is that Spirit is saying there is huge regret here on your part, my fire signs, is that you didn't think things through and you acted before. You acted before you walked. I'm trying to phrase this in such a nice way, but sometimes it's very difficult to do that. Spirit is saying that you may have caused the problem for yourself by acting without thinking, by walking away. Without thinking about things. You know, there was confusion here. But Spirit wants you to compromise now. You don't have to give up, is what Spirit's saying. Compromise if that's what it takes. You know, this is healing, a renewal here. Spirit is also saying here as well with Justice, this person may have hurt you, you may have hurt them, it may have been an equal thing here, but Spirit is saying this can be fixed. Someone just needs to take that step to apologise, and it looks like you may need to be the one to apologise, because I do feel like it may have been you guys that may have been in the wrong here. So, but there is hope. Happiness here, healing. Spirit saying this is a win-win solution, basically. So I'm going to leave that there on that, and let's get you some oracle cards because I feel you guys need it. So let's get a message here for you. So for my fire signs, please, Spirit. Believe. Look at that. Love it. So look, we have believe. So, believe in magic. How many of you believe in magic in your world? We are not talking about the illusion of magical tricks, but the magic and change through actions of love. And we've seen so much love in this reading, and I feel like that is what Spirit is saying as well. Be open to love, show that love to this person, and all will be forgiven. Because I do feel like whoever this is, this Hierophant here, is someone very wise, you know, very forgiving. So anyway, love is the underlying positive energy of everything that is magical. From the elemental realms of your multidimensional earth to the first breath of at birth of a human child. This could be your child or it could be your parent. Magic happens through kindness, compassion, and great understanding of the world around you. Magic happens in times of peace of mind when you connect to the unlimited boundaries of the universe. You are the magic that brings change. Use the love you have in your heart and your internal love for you to bring the magical changes you desire for yourself. That's a lovely card for you guys. That's beautiful. So let's get him. Oh, throat went there. It only happens when I do readings. Okay. Message from your higher selves. So advice your higher self will give you. If I can shuffle. Okay, you got quite a few. So we've got destined for greatness. It's your destiny to be great. It's coded in your DNA. Time to meet your greater self. So in your DNA, guys, there's something about you that spirit is saying that you are destined to be someone very important by the looks of it. Maybe part of that as well is forgiveness. Almost there. You have come this far to give up now. The seeds you've planted are beginning to flourish. So maybe some of you guys have been working really hard, and maybe some of you guys are thinking, oh, it's not really going anywhere. But then it could be about this as well. Nothing is lost. Know that when you lose something, try to remember that there is always a deeper meaning. That anything you lose comes around in another form, and no matter how bad things may seem, all is not lost. And that's what you're getting from this reading as well. It's not lost. Hidden treasure. The treasure you are looking for is hidden in the ground you're standing on. It's time to dig deeper. So that could be, you know, Kundalini. That could be meditation. Connect to spirit. Maybe there's more that you need to know. Important mission. Your soul has an important mission to fulfill in this lifetime. Search within and you'll discover your mission. There you go. So maybe they're the two that are connected here. Okay. So for my fire signs, please, spirit. What message do you have? So we have Lynx, keeper of secrets. Take time out from the world and be the observer. Nothing can deceive you when you trust your knowing. You see other secrets and keep them sacred in silence and solitude. You will find your strength. So spirit could be saying here, don't reveal any secrets that were given to you. Observe people as well. You know, it could be maybe you're being lied to as well. Raven, shaman. You are the creator and magician. Use your gifts for good. So that might be a message right there for you, fire signs, okay? Because there's an important mission. You need to find out what that is. And this is saying raven and shaman. So anyway, you are the creator and magician. Use your gifts for good. There is power in your wisdom of words. Connect with the elemental spirits and guide through the void. Claim your place as keeper of the mysteries. Okay, I feel that might be what you guys need to be focusing on. Consult an expert. More information is needed. Contact with expertise in this area. So it could be maybe to do with this here, or it could be to do with when I said that you may need to speak to someone that may be able to advise you on what to do, what actions to take. Maybe you're a bit confused. That's why you're delaying reaching out. Not that many. Let's do that again. Can I have one more? Oh, they nearly flew out again. Oh my god. Right, do you know what? Let's done that again. Let's just take them. Sorry I'm boring you, but anyway. Healing heart. You're a powerful healer. Keep up the great work. So this is what I'm saying. It's something to do with your heart. You've had the Ace of Cups twice. Love. Sometimes loving someone and forgiving someone, or, you know, there's something very healing about you guys. Anyway, a new dawn. The worst is now behind you and positive new experiences are on the horizon. Make a wish. This is a magical moment. Make a wish and enjoy the manifestation. So make a wish, guys. Contemplation time. Spend time alone, meditating upon what you truly desire. And then we have protection. You, your loved ones, and your possessions are safe and protected by heaven. So there's a lot of messages there for you guys. So let's get one of these for you. I'm not taking that many. Bloody hell. Let's take that one. On whom am I placing blame right now? Oh, wow. Okay. Let's have a look. A person who blames others has not begun their lesson. A person who blames themselves has begun their lesson. That, do you know what? Yeah. A person who blames no one has fit... A person who blames no one has finished their lesson. So this could be where you're at this stage now, where you know, I said nobody won in this. You felt defeated, they feel defeated, but it's, you know, are you still blaming this person? Because then that means you've not learned the lesson yet, is what Spirit's saying. That could be why things are delayed, why you're not reaching out. Maybe you're still blaming this person for what happened. So anyway, today's soul action. Take responsibility. On whom are you placing blame right now? Today, free yourself by releasing all victimhood, blame and resistance. They don't belong where you are going. Only love and courage live there. Make a choice to do it. Even if you don't feel ready, listen to your heart. You will be led. So some of you may not even be ready to forgive this person for whatever happened. But this is a really important message right there. I've always said forgiveness is key. You can forgive the person from afar. You don't need to get in touch if that's what you don't want to do. But this could be holding you back from, you know, your spiritual journey here. There's something really good up here, but I'm not going to go into that because that's not what this is about. But yeah, forgiveness is key. I've always said that. So anyway, my lovely fire signs, I'm going to leave it there. You have a lovely day, guys. Much love.